Has Travis peaked?
Yeah.
Has Cardi peaked?
Yeah.
Has Gunna peaked?
No.
Even with the Rico?
I mean, if he gets to make more music, no.
Yeah.
Especially, let me not.
I feel relentless, ambition with a clear vision. Taking off, I ain't taking off these pistons. I'm taking off on the enemy, your distance. Came across me, how much it cost me to get you out my business.
Oh, because what, like, by the time we were really tapped in, when do you think you were really, like, tapped in with music and, like, kind of knew what was going on and what people were on? 12, 13?
Yeah, I would say for me, probably, like, yeah, probably 13, 14.
13, 14, like, right about to go into high school. Mm-hmm. He had already dropped the Carter 4. Mm-hmm. He was already declining.
Yeah.
I don't want to say declining. That sounds negative, but no, he was.
It was a different time for him. I think he was already, you know. It's okay to have a peak.
Yeah, you need to.
I don't think you ever know when it is.
Yeah.
But like, it happens. You know what I mean? And then you just like, it's cool that you can keep going after a lot of people. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
do you think you might have a good gauge of when peaks are? You think you kind of have some... An indicator of when someone's peaking?
Yeah.
Okay. Has Kendrick peaked?
Yeah.
Has Travis peaked?
Yeah.
Has Cardi peaked?
Yeah.
Has Gunna peaked?
No.
Even with the Rico?
I mean, if he gets to make more music, no.
Yeah.
Especially, let me not. But yeah.
Let me not. Has Kodak peaked?
No.
No? Has Baby peaked?
No.
Easily not. Has Push peaked? That's easy.
Yeah.
He definitely has.
Mm.
He definitely has.
Yeah. It's just been like kind of like.
Yeah.
For him. But yeah.
All right. Let me think of one more. Has ASAP Rocky peaked?
No.
No. I agree.
And like when we say peak, you're talking like release their best work, right?
Yeah, they still might have plenty left in the tank post peak. Yeah, it could be like
they just haven't reached, they haven't made their best shit yet.
You know, you could stay at peak for a long time at a very gradual decline for years and years and years, but like is their best work behind them?
The most difficult one to say was Travis.
More than Kendrick?
Bro, To Pimp a Butterfly, like
yeah, but like the potential.
But like that. For me, it's when you do everything. Music was dope. Genre pushing. Cultural impact. The time it came out at. The messaging. The artwork. You know what I mean? Like, the way he promoted it. The way he...
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, you're right.
You know what I mean? Like, I pull it... you know, like, I don't see him dropping something at that point yet. Because also, like, it's hard to peak... After you're big.
Hard to peak after. Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know,
because you probably got big for a reason.
I think the rare occasion was Kanye.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because I think, you know, you could... My favorite's going to be Cause Dropout, but I think My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy was like... You know the what peak? I mean? Yeah.
Okay. Has Tyler peaked? Mm-mm. Nah, he hasn't.
But
he
hasn't. Yeah, nah.
I'm just thinking about it in the terms of realistically, can I see this artist making a better project than what I consider the best project? So with Tyler, I'm like, realistically, do I see a world where in 2 years or whatever, Tyler has the chance of dropping a project that's better than Igor? And I can see it.
I've gotten to the point with Igor where not only do I love it now, I think when I'm 50 years old...
Mm-hmm.
I may listen to it and like shed a tear.
It's a perfect album, bro.
Like it's a really like I think that shit's gonna age amazing. But yeah, I think Tyler.
And that's why like the Rocky answer was so spot on. Next time Rocky drops, do I realistically think there's a chance that he drops a project better than At Long Last ASAP? Fuck yes. That's probably a 9 for me. That album's maybe even a 10. It might be. Bro, I had moments with that album. I love that album.
That's not a 10, bro.
What misses?
What do you mean?
What misses are on that?
It's not a miss, bro. It's like, what's like, what? It's Blonde. Blonde is a 10.
Oh my God. This is by far ASAP Rocky's best work.
Yeah. But that's no. Bro,
and it has
no
some.
I think the nigga has 2 9s.
What, that and
testing?
You're crazy, bro. That is not the same as testing.
No.
It's not ranked the same as testing.
No, that's fair. That's fair to say that, Alfred.
Bump testing down or give at long last a 10.
Or just slap testing. You know,
I do slap testing. Dog. I do, bro. Testing's cool.
Twin, hey, if you like Igor, there's no way you don't love testing.
Yeah, there is.
Bruh.
Hear me out.
Give it like, bro, like, you know what I mean? Like, get in your vibe. Get in your vibe, bro. Just get in your vibe, bro.
Bro,
you know what I'm saying? Get in the bag. Can you get in the bag?
Igor is my beautiful dark twisted fantasy where testing is Yeezus.
Okay.
And you know how I feel about Yeezus.
Exactly. So then maybe put some more respect on its name. I'm not even saying it's better than the other album. I'm not even saying it's better than At Long Last, bro. I'm saying they're like fucking equal.
No.
Bro. I'm telling you. Get in your bag and really listen to that album, bro.
Yeah.
Because what he was talking on, like, not even the way that he was talking, even though, like, he literally learned how to, like, because Rocky's one of the best technical rappers we have in the game. But he was so specific with his word choice and, like, his storytelling on that album. His storytelling was incredible. Like, nobody's made music that sounds like this.
Yeah.
This is one of the most unique sonic albums, like, sonically unique albums I've heard in a very long time from a rapper.
Yeah.
And he was really I think
At Long Last is more sonically unique.
Nah, bro, because that's testing. Bro, that's so in his wheelhouse. That like
Yeah, but it's a wheelhouse that has never been done before. He hadn't done it before. He hadn't done it before.
Yes, he had, bro.
No.
Phoenix?
No.
Phoenix could be on that album.
One song. Bro, one song.
Fucking Purple Swag could be on there.
On At Long Bro, but neither of those songs are like the polish on this thing is perfect,
bro.
From top to bottom, bro. Holy Ghost,
there's is no misses.
Insane intro,
there's no misses.
Fine Wine, bro,
there's
and
no misses.
And the highs are just as high as the high on anything else. Lord Pretty Flaco, Jordy 2.
There's no misses.
Excuse Me,
yeah.
JD, Electric Body with Q.
Yes. You're explaining an album. That's what I'm saying. That's what I feel like is missing right now.
Jukebox Joints.
I am not. I think you want me to move testing down, but I already hold this album in a high regard.
Well, you didn't say it was a 10. This is the definition of a 10. Wavy Bone with Juicy J?
Nah, okay, because just because an album don't have no misses doesn't make it a 10.
But it has some of the best rap music I've ever heard on here.
Kanye
Back
have?
Home with Mos Def?
How many 10s does Kanye have?
Kanye's got 1, 2, 3, 4 to 5.
Nah, fam.
Yeah?
Nah, fam. I think he
3 to 5.
I think he might, yeah, like two. He has 2 10s.
No, 3 obvious.
He's 2 10s.
No.
No, I'll give him 3 10s. I'll give him 3 10s.
You just don't respect Yeezus like you need
to. Yeezus was the 3rd 10.
Okay, there you go, there you go, there you go. So we agree that College Dropout, Twisted Fantasy, and Yeezus are 10s. And I think you can make great cases for Late Registration 808s.
Yeah, but you're not going to trip if they 9s, right?
No, I'll give them 9s.
Exactly. And are those just as good as this album?
No, this is better than 808s. Twin! This is better than 808s okay. Heartbreaks.
Cool.
And it's better than Larry's Station.
Stand, look in the camera and say that.
At Long Last, ASAP is better than 808s and Heartbreaks and Late Registration. Yes, it is. I believe
that.
I believe that.
That's fucking hilarious, bro.
This is a great poster. That album changed everything. Hey, man, I can't tell you, but
I'm happy that I already know what the intro to the fucking podcast is going to be.
Like I was saying earlier, bro, you don't need anyone to validate your opinion. I know what this album has done for me.
But that's what I'm saying.
I know how special this is.
Now
this album is better.
Remember what I was trying to say at the beginning of this. You do need someone to tell you when you're wrong. But bullying is in certain situations.
Why?
Bro. If you go through life
thinking that this is better than 808s.
No, I'm speaking in a general perspective. But like, yes, if we want to break it down to this, if you go through life seriously thinking that you could claim that this album, like, and I love this album. That's why I think this shit is so crazy. You're making me talk about this album in a negative way, bro. That shit is not better than 808s and Heartbreak.
Yeah, it is.
Bro, yeah, they're the same level. Cool. I'll even go with that, bro.
Well, okay, you said 808s. Oh, no, okay. You said it was a 9.
Like, what, bro? Come on.
This is a 10.
Just say that this is as good as... That's as good as Blonde, bro?
Blonde's a classic. Blonde is beyond 10.
That's what a 10 is.
No.
A 10 is a...
And no.
There we go.
There's an extra step up from a 10. 10 is not the max you can reach. Yes, there is.
Why would we say rate it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I don't know. You like to rate things on a scale of 1 to 7, so you don't come to me talking about a scale.
Why you called it a 10? That's the highest you
can go. Maybe I'm rating out of 11. Dog. You always do the bullshit scales, bro. I'm just taking a page out of your book.
But I know you're not. I know you're not.
But there's a step above 10 for me. for me. Bro. Maybe I should have clarified that before I start calling all these tens. Mm-hmm. But I go 1 through 10 and classic at the top. And classic, normally, I think you need 5 to 10 years with. Blonde, I'll rush order classic because that's obviously a classic.
This nigga copping the fuck out.
That's what do you mean? Crazy, what do you mean?
Dog, if you going to call something a 10, you're going to call it a 10. They need to be on the same playing field.
Well, you
can't separate blonde and put it on a different tier than this shit, bro.
Yes, you if can, bro. If you
call some shit a 10, it's going to be compared to 10s because every 10, when it stacks up against the rest of them, stands up. Because I think blonde stands up against What's Going On by Marvin Gaye. You know what I mean?
We could go so back. They're equal level. They're equal. They're equal. No, neither is better than the other.
Blonde and those two? Yeah. Those are equal level.
Any classic.
Yeah. Like, then they could stand next to each other. Like, if somebody said any of the classic albums, like, one was better than another, I can't say you're wrong. Because it's just, at that point, it's personal preference. But I could factually say that, like, all of those albums are better than this shit. And they're tens.
Disagree.
Bro. Is this as good as Good Kid, Mad City?
Mm-hmm. They're very much on the same level. That's a great comparison.
To Pimp a Butterfly?
No.
You calling that a classic? You rushing that a classic
yes.
too?
Yes. That is that extra level.
Awaken My Love.
Ooh. Yeah, it's right here with this.
Amen.
Awaken My Love, that one I'm just trying to take personal bias away from. Because I feel very special about that album, though.
There's no personal bias. It's a 10.
Yeah.
Just that like is that. Not a 10. And I love
you. You don't think Rocky has any 10s?
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, I know he has more in the tank, bro. Like, I don't think there's... Because let me preface this again. No misses on this album.
Yeah.
Top to bottom, no misses. But there's moments that I want more. I just want a little more. There's more there. There's just more there. It doesn't feel like this. Like, I feel like Rocky himself.
I don't know, bro. I don't know. This is pretty fucking good.
Here's what I'm saying. I genuinely feel like if you had Rocky go back and talk about these albums,
yeah,
he would still be able to tell you things that he would do differently. I don't think a lot of people would say that about their classics. Like their tens, like their ones, bro. Like there's I don't know. And like, you know what I mean? Who cares at the end of the day? Yeah. But, ugh.
This is there, bro. This is there. This is an insane project.
Yeah, bro, but it's like.
How many tens does Trav have? Any? One?
I'm going to give him one.
Just Rodeo?
Yeah. Just Rodeo. Good. Is a 10. Just Rodeo is a 10. That's what I'm saying, bro. I could be realistic, bro. Like, I could, like because we just listened to Days Before.
I'll probably take this over Rodeo.
Man. Niggas is talking a lot, bro.
I'll probably take a long last ASAP over Rodeo. You're really, I think you're not giving this album enough credit.
You're dick riding crazy right now, bro.
I think I'm the only one that, if I'm the only one that has the opinion, then I'm the only one that accurately is assessing him when we say he's one of the best in the game. Because you're not going to tell me he's one of the best in the game.
I will.
And tell me he has no tens.
Why?
Well, I mean, that's valid, but like, no.
Why?
No.
Why?
No. He had the body.
Isaiah Rashad, no tens.
Yeah, agreed. He's not on the same level as Rocky.
Bro.
You think he's on the same level as Rocky?
Yes.
I don't. Bro. I don't. Bro. I just don't.
Why?
I just don't. Because he's not, and you know he's not.
Why?
Because he's not, bro. Rocky is a whole moment in time. Rocky is like cement. He's an icon.
Okay, just he's an icon. But
he changed music. He changed music.
What? How?
We already did this. Bro. We already did this whole thing, but bro. Like, bro. With but the like, Houston influence and like, starting psych rap. We already did this. We already had this conversation, bro.
Was he really like? He's an innovator, right? He's an icon. All that shit. All the fashion shit, whatever, right? But, like, to claim this nigga is, like, astronomically better than someone who has put out 3 projects that are on par with his 3 best projects.
Where did astronomically come from? Who said astronomically? Astronomically.
Fair.
And Zay's projects are great, but I'd say there's a big drop off from this album to Zay's best project, but I would say that I think all three of Zay's albums are better than Rocky's second best project.
How can you say someone is better if they have three albums better than their second best album?
Yeah.
And the only thing that they have better is one. I'm not even saying Zay's better. I'm saying they're on par. Yeah. That is the definition of them literally being equals.
No, it's not. Where'd you get that definition?
Bro, just look at the numbers, bro. If we want to do mathematical averages.
Yeah.
And we're doing album by album, bro.
I don't think that's a fair way to assess people, mathematically averaging them.
You're the one who literally said his one album is better than Zay's first, but then Zay's three is better than his two. You the one who brought up numbers.
Yeah, bro. Well, it's not about quantity, bro. Isn't your favorite rapper Lauryn Hill?
No. No, not at all.
Don't you love Lauryn Hill?
Yes.
Don't you think she's the best?
Best what?
Don't you just think she's awesome?
Yes.
Don't you think she's the best?
At what?
At rapping?
No.
And singing and making music about being miseducated?
Bro, that's what I'm saying, bro. This nigga tripping, bro. We can talk about Travis, bro, because I'm happy for him to be performing again.